Welcome back to Time Series Analysis. Today, we are going to look at more filtering, more process, and start by looking at once I was out running, and if you're looking at this, the question is, what did I actually do? Well, I can see I followed this trajectory somewhat, but you can also see there's quite a bit of noise in this here. It was basically my phone that was out of order at this point in time, and I was running just straight and then made a turn and up there. But how does all that work? Getting back to where we were last week, we're talking about state-space models. We are getting back to the Kalman filter. We're talking about some examples how to look at all the previous processes that some of the previous processes we looked at, what happens if we add observation noise to that. I'm coming with some examples again. And also how to estimate parameters in this kind of model. So just to revisit, we have the linear stochastic state space model. We have the system equation here. X is the state of the system. You have a linear difference equation for this, and you can have some input, and you have some system noise as well. And then you have the observation equation where you observe some linear function of x plus some observation noise. So that's the starting point for all this. Now, what we looked at previously is, among other things, ARMA models, or ARMA models to be more general, but here we'll just restrict ourselves to ARMA models. So what we want to talk about is we can take any ARMA PQ model, and then we can rewrite it as a state space model. The state space model is a little bit reduced compared to the usual thing, because we assume that there's no observation noise. We can add that later if needed in particular case. And then the noise up here is only univariate, whereas in the general setting, it's multivariate. So what we do is that we take all the AR coefficients here, parameters, put that in the first column with negative sign, and then we put a unity matrix here and end out with a row of zeros in the bottom. That's the general setting. Then we have, for the moving average part, we have start with a 1, because we want the first element of the x state here to represent time t, and then so we have to have epsilon t there, and then we can take, if there are moving average parts, we add those up into the equation there. Now, of course, you may not always have as many thetas and phis as in this particular case. So we have d there and d minus 1 there, and some of these may be 0. So the order of the dimension of this is either is the maximum of p and q plus 1. The q plus 1 comes from the fact that you need this one up here to keep track of that. So how does this work in practice? Let's just look at a simple model and see, can we actually understand what is going on? So let's make an example of an AR2 model. We're going to look at what the process comes out. We're trying to fill in the gaps. Let's fill in first what is known. We have the system matrix here with a unity matrix of order of dimension 1, and then a row of zeros. And then what was the state before? And then epsilon is a 1, 0 on epsilon t. So what we have over here is xt, and here we have xt minus 1. And if we just fill in an element, what we have up here at the first element is x1, comma, the time t minus 1. So given this number up here, we can see what are we going to get in the second element at time t. We're going to get minus phi 2 of this one up here. So minus phi 2 x1, comma, t minus 1. Now, given that we have this, then when we then look forward, one step forward in time, this will move over here and become minus phi 2 x1, comma, and then the time shift from t to t minus 1 means that the t minus 1 becomes t minus 2. So now what is left is to write what comes out up here. So let's start from the top here. we have minus phi 1 x 1 comma t minus 1. Then we have minus, then we have the 1 there times what we have down here, minus phi 2 x 1 comma t minus 2. And then we have plus epsilon t. And this up here is indeed an AR2 process for the first state in there. So if we have C to just observe the first state, then we did indeed reproduce an AR2 model on a state space formulation.